Hello Scorpio Rising, welcome to your Avalon Rituals reading. My name is Julia, thank you for tuning in, and yes, you have heard right. It is about your rising sign. So if your rising sign is Scorpio, then you just continue listening. If you have another rising sign, please check out the other videos. Alright, so what is this about? It's about the conjunction of Saturn and Pluto that is today. And today is the 12th of January 2020, so I thought I'm going to use the energies to tune into your energies and see how this conjunction is affecting you in your life right now. And how you do this is by looking at your rising sign. This is why it is so important to check your rising sign. And also, this rising sign says basically in what house this conjunction is happening. So that again means you can see in what area of life. And for you, let's have a little look. Oh yeah, it's the third. It's a third house. So that's the house of communication, of the way you think, and communicating also in a written way. So what I have done is I have done the Lina Moore spread as usual, because I just love the Lina Moore spread, but I also have the tarot cards, because I thought, you know what, let's combine this and then have a look into this specific area of communication and how this is affecting you. And Saturn and Pluto are causing massive changes at the moment. This is not just like, oh yeah, there's a little bit of a change. It's a massive change. This is why I felt guided to really do the readings for you, because it could be quite intense. And it is about Saturn, who is the structure and also karma. And then there is Pluto, and Pluto is the destroyer, death and rebirth. And it's about really ripping away everything that is not longer serving us to build the new that is more in alignment with who we are now. And for you, this is the way of thinking. So there's probably a shift for you in the way how you think and therefore how you communicate. So that's super interesting. And let's have a look at the Lina Moore in a second. But first, I want to show you the cards that I have here. Okay, so worries. I do feel like you are an overthinker. You're overthinking quite a lot. But I do feel like there comes some awareness, some consciousness, that actually it's in your control what you think about and therefore how you feel. Because our thoughts can create our emotions, and of course the other way around. But this is about the thinking. So I do feel like you are realizing that you actually can change the way you feel by the way you think. And this is indicated by, I do feel like, those two cards here. We have the Emperor and we have the King of Air, the King of Swords. And I do feel like this is about structure. This is about making a plan and protection. This is also the Divine Masculine, like the father figure. And it's about really taking care of yourself, and maybe even have boundaries, but also set yourself the boundaries and be really clear. This is the King of Communication. It is the King of thoughts, basically, and be really clear in your communication, but also in your thoughts, which means catch yourself and be like, no, you know what, I'm now going to take responsibility and control over my thought processes, because I want to step out of the negative thinking or the negative spiral. You want to step out of this, and it feels like you have the strength and the clarity it needs now for you to step out of these negative thinkings or the thought spirals. And this is leading to the Abundant card, the Nine of Pentacles, which is really, really beautiful. So it's just a little adjustment in the way you're thinking, and then your life is definitely gonna become more easy for you, because you're not going down these spirals. So let's have a look now onto the Lina Moore spread. All right, Scorpio Rising, what I did was I charged one card, and that was the letter for your third house of communication and thinking. And another thing that I want to say is that If you are new to the Lenormand, one card is always indicated by you, and that is in this case the female person. So no matter if you are a man or a woman, this card is now indicating you, and this card would indicate your love interest, your ex-partner, future partner, or your partner that you have at the moment. Okay, when I saw this, and when I saw the cards popping up around the matter of thinking and communication, I was thinking, what the fuck? Are you kidding? Are you kidding me? Really? Every aspect of life that people want to look into is around this, which is like, oh my God, I don't know where to start. Communication and thinking about like your home life, your immediate environment, your social circle, your love life, your work, also your beliefs, but also karma, your finances, beauty and harmony. Also, again, this can be a card of family, journeys and travel and spirituality. So it's like, I don't know what's happening for you, but it's like there is a massive shift in the way you think or communicate of every area of life. Literally, like, I don't even know where to start at with this. So what I thought is that I'm going to do the path of dot dot dot, which means the path of now, your communication, your way of thinking. And we're gonna come directly, we're gonna come directly here to this card. So the letter here, which is your communication and thinking, is leading to the fox. And this is leading to, okay, positive changes. So I do feel with the fox that you are very clever, you're very intellectual, but that is also a little bit, I don't want to say downfall, but it can keep you in the negative spiral. Because if we are clever, we are intellectual, and we are overthinking. So this is the same energy that I feel that I had in the tarot deck. So this overthinking and really being in the mind, but there are positive changes, and the positive changes also relate to see things clearer now, maybe even see things clearer for what they are, realizing, getting the clarity, oh, I can't continue having the same mindset because it's just not benefiting me, it's just too much. That's it. That's why we have all of the card. It's too much. You think about everything and in such an intensity. It's like, that's what I meant. The energy of, you know, I don't even know how to start here because it's that, it's this. And it feels like if you started thinking about the love and then you are overthinking, and then it's like, the house situation, the finances and all these things. And it feels like you get the realization that you need to stop this, and you get the clarity that the blockages that you created, the blockages yourself, and it might have an effect on other areas of your life because of your overthinking that is literally stopping you because you feel so overburdened. You feel like, oh no, now I thought about this, I thought about that, I thought about the other thing, and now I just feel like overwhelmed by my life. But it's the way you're thinking, and that was the blockage. Let's have a look. What is this leading to? 4, 3, 2, 1. This is leading to the park. So this could mean a public event or the public in general. And also there might be an invitation coming for you that is going to be really lucky, and it's going to bring you new stability, and this is going to lead to new luck, and the luck is also spreading out into your immediate environment, your home life, and also your social circle. So I do feel like realizing that this blockage is so much self-made, and maybe there is something happening on a public event, maybe that is a key situation, because also we have the transformation here next to it. So maybe this invitation or going somewhere, maybe taking a journey somewhere, somewhere where it's really beautiful, where the nature is really nice, maybe going into nature. Also, this could mean creativity and going into creative processes and like being in some kind of meditation while you are creating things. So this could also be a meaning here. And this is, as I've said, whatever this is, it's gonna bring you more stability within yourself. You are more grounded. And that's, of course, a super lucky thing in general, always. But this is having an immediate effect on your immediate environment, on your friend circle. This is leading to... oh my God. Oh yeah, I already said this. A journey that is destined to happen. Maybe there is again some karma involved, but not all karma is bad, right? So there is a journey that you're taking. And maybe, as I've said, this could be because of this invitation, but I do feel like this invitation or this public or these creative processes are really helping you to how do you say, detangle or entangle, well, to sort out your mind. And that is really, really, really interesting. Really interesting. There are still, what I get here is that there are probably some complications, but there is some new knowledge that is coming in, and this new knowledge is leading. Maybe you want to withdraw a little bit from the world, and maybe you feel like now, with having these knowledge, the new insights and realizations, maybe you're like, you know what, I really need some peace and harmony here. And because I do feel like there was a lot going on in your life. And if it wasn't like a lot was going on, then you made a lot going on because of your thought processes. But use the energies at the moment with Saturn and Pluto. And change the way you think and the way you communicate, therefore. And I do feel like this is going to have a massive, massive awakening quality for you. All right. I hope this resonated with you. If so, please leave me a comment or a like or subscribe to the channel. I'm looking so much forward to do the next reading for you guys. And I'm sending you so much love from Avalon, and see you next time.